Join me in a song of praise. Church, if you don't mind, let's take out the time to offer up a worthy song of praise. Join me in a song. Truth, past religious dark byways, we're anchored in the truth. Let's create an atmosphere, bid the angels to draw near, for it's time we sing a worthy song of praise.
Spirit moving me to give. Praise the Lord. Oh, you may be seated just for a while. Certainly want to greet you all in the precious name of our King, the Lord Jesus Christ. Just certainly thank God for this privilege to stand at this spot of ground this morning. Amen. I still don't sound myself. Amen. But by the grace of God, hallelujah. He is our strength this morning. Just want to bring greetings this morning. Brother Brady said to greet you all. And so I bring greetings from Brother Brady. And Sister Ivy Edwards is here this morning. Certainly glad to have her. Amen. And it's really a privilege that she could come on the side this time, and her daughter had a surprise birthday party for her. And, you know, she extended also to us, really. You know, she couldn't take everybody, but for those who came to represent the church, I mean, it was really a grand affair. And I told her yesterday that she certainly look 20 years younger today than the time she left here for England. You know, and so I said, when I get to that age, I want to look like Sister Ivy, young and fit. Eh? No, I don't want to go to England. Incidentally, I have an invitation to go, and I'm still praying about it. But, you know, certainly glad that she could do that, and it shows the love and the respect of her children to her, you know, and also their love and respect to the church that they have extended that so that we also could sharing with the rest of the family. And so we had a good time, and I was glad to be identified with all of that. Then also she bring greetings from Brother Peter Chandler at the London Christian Assembly. That's the name. Right, the London Christian Assembly. And Brother Lawson and his wife and Sister Rose. And I remember Sister Monica was here, Sister Verona, and the different ones, you know, said to greet you in the precious name of the King, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And it's certainly good when you know that not only in this little house that you're standing, but elsewhere you've got brothers and sisters who love you and pray with you and pray for you. You know, it shows the ministry of the many-membered body of Jesus Christ. Amen? Amen? We don't have to be at the same place to love one another. We don't have to be at the same place to be in fellowship with one another. But wherever we are, the bride of Jesus Christ, amen, we have such sweet fellowship and love one for the other. Amen. This morning also we have Dr. Missy at church this morning. Glad to have him. Amen. And so, Doctor, we're glad to have you in church with the family this morning. And I told him, I implore him, I said, I want to see those children in Sunday school. You have a responsibility for that. Amen? The Bible says we train up our children in the way they should grow, that when they're whole, they never depart from it. Amen? And so that is the experience this morning. This morning, you know, we thank God for the family of God. I thank God for all those who have prayed for me and remember me and call me and go through this sickness with me. And, you know, I tell you the truth, I never prayed for myself that I be well, because I just say, Lord, that's my body telling me that I just need some rest and I'll just take the rest. Amen? And so this week I rested. And yesterday I got up in the morning and I had breakfast sometime, and, you know, I had a number of things that I had to do. And so Francine was still in bed, so I went and I lied down beside her, and I was talking to her, and I was telling her that the different things I have to do. And she said, lie down in your bed and sleep. And it seemed like she put a spell on me. And I slept all day long. And so in the evening I didn't know it was evening. I thought it was still morning. And so I got up and I get dressed and I was going to do my duties. And so I went, I stopped, I talked to Sister Ivy, and then I go to the road and I turn back. And when I was coming back, I look at the vehicle and it was saying 3 something at the clock. And I said, who interfered with my vehicle? The clock not working. And so I take out my phone and I look. It was 3 something in the evening. And I was thinking that it was still morning and I haven't had breakfast yet. You know, you're having a early morning stroll before breakfast. It was the end of the day. When you get there, you know that 25 past you the second time. Amen? You're not the way you used to be. Amen. But I'm glad I got the rest, you know, and so, and I still feel like I need rest. You know, that's just what I need. But and sometimes God's got to do something to you to get you to slow down a little bit. Amen? And we certainly thank God for that. Amen. But we thank God for the faithfulness of the body of Christ. You know, Brother Kevin was sick. Brother Garfield was sick. Brother Glenn was sick. Brother Wayne was sick. I said, God, you passed through our whole house. Amen. But we're still here this morning. Amen? Still here. And I was working with Brother Smith last Saturday. We're working together. And I got sick, and I realized everybody who worked with him throughout the week got sick. And he's not sick. Amen. Amen. But God is good. Amen? God is good. Brother Dixon said yesterday he felt it. And so, but I think he shaked that off. And he's here this morning. Amen. How many glad to be in the house of God? Amen. And how many glad for the family of God? Amen. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. You know, one thing I pray for is that the house being loved. Amen. that above everything else, you love one another with an undying love. Amen? Amen. That you care for one another. Amen. That if any has a fault, amen, you pray for that one. Amen. If one is overtaken with a fault, you restore such a one in the spirit of meekness. Is that what the Bible says? Yes. Amen. We don't push out any. We don't push aside any. Amen. But together we are the family of God. Amen. And the members of the body of Jesus Christ. Amen. I'd like to go to the word this morning. If you stand on your feet in 2 Corinthians chapter 3, this word has been ringing out in my mind. I also have a note from Sister King. And, you know, I tell you, I said to Sister King, Sister King, where did you learn to write? Because for a older woman, she's certainly a writer. You know that? Sister King is certainly a writer. But she wrote this morning, she said she's not very well. But she certainly believed that God will take care of her, you know, and she will be well. And she said she had a dream that she was sharing that, you know, she was in church. And she said, a truckload of food drive up at the church. And I was giving out the food. It wasn't cooked food, but I was giving out the food to everybody. And she said, that is good luck. So good luck to you all this morning. Amen. Trust God you all get a part of the food. If you ain't getting none, it's because you don't want none. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. May we just bow our heads everywhere. Almighty God and our Father, we want to thank you, God, for this day you have given to us. Heavenly Father, Lord God, we said send the anointing of the Holy Spirit to change the atmosphere this morning, God. Because Lord God, what a house of needs this morning. But Lord God, thou art still Jehovah Jireh. You are still our provider, Lord God. You're still our healer, our problem solver. Lord, you're still the burden bearer. Lord God, and you are here in your house this morning, oh God. And marvel yourself like you did yesterday, that, oh God, we can see beyond the veil this morning and see you face to face. Bless us this morning, God. Lord, may the weak say, I'm strong in the Lord. Heavenly Father, for every need that is here this morning, Lord God, we know you've got the answer. Lord God, many have prayed for long for many things that is on their heart. But Lord God, we know that Lord Jesus, you said whatsoever thing we desire, Lord, we can say to that mountain. And Lord God, we come believing the same word because Lord God, we know that your word is eternally settled in heaven. And so Lord God, we are pressing forward, believing in you this morning. Bless us now as we look to you and believe you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. I want you also to remember Brother Bernard Van Ransburg is going to be here from the 20th to the, from the 21st to the 27th. He's going to be with us here in Jamaica. Just remember him in your prayers. I'm going to try to take him to the other fellowships and let him share around at least a Sunday. I expect him to be here with us. Amen, to have service. Amen? Amen. In 2 Corinthians chapter 3, I read from verse 7. But if the ministration of death, written and engraved in stones, was glorious, so that the children of Israel could not steadfastly behold the face of Moses for the glory of his countenance, which glory was to be done away. How shall not the ministration of the Spirit be rather glorious? For if the ministration of condemnation be glorious, much more does the ministration of righteousness exceed in glory. For even that which was made glorious had no glory in this respect, by reason of the glory that excelleth. For if that which is done away was glorious, much more that which remain is glorious. Seeing then that we have such hope, we use great plainness of speech, and not as Moses, which put a veil over his face, that the children of Israel could not steadfastly look to the end of that which is abolished. But their minds were blinded, for until this day remaineth the same veil untaken away in the reading of the Old Testament, which veil is done away in Christ. But even unto this day, when Moses read, the veil is upon their heart. Nevertheless, when it shall turn to the Lord, the veil shall be taken away. Now the Lord is that Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. But we all, with open face, beholding as in a glass the glory of the Lord, are changed into the same image from glory to glory, even as by the Spirit of the Lord. May the Lord add his blessing to the reading of your word. You may be seated. I'd like to speak this morning on unveiling the mystery of Christ. Unveiling the mystery of Christ. You see, the whole essence of the scripture, the Bible, the Word of God, is centered around Jesus Christ. Amen? Amen. Everything that God did from the book of Genesis, it was centered around Christ. It was to make Christ, bring Christ in plain view to the believer. And that's the only way that the believer would have a position in Jesus Christ or know their own position if they see that position in the glory and the light of Jesus Christ. Amen? And so God himself, all that God was doing, John says in St. John 1, he said, in the beginning was the Word. And Brother Branham tells us that the Word is the Logos that came from God. Is that right? Amen. But he went back to the beginning and he said, even before the beginning, before he was God, he said, because in Genesis 1, he said, and God said, and he said, that is not the true interpretation, because God is an object of worship. And if there was nothing created, then there was nothing to worship God. So he said, there he was, the self-existing one. He existed by himself. He exists with his attribute. His attribute is actually his thoughts. Is that right? And so everything that came from God, before it came from God, it was in God. Is that right? And so if you are here this morning as the manifestation of God, it means that you are in God before the world began. Is that right? Then we find that everything that was in God must go back to God. Jesus it was that says, for I come from God and I'm going back to God. Right. Are you there with me? Amen. Amen. He knew exactly who he was. He know where he come from. And you the same, you've got to know who you are. You've got to know where you come from, what you proceed from. And so you can say who I am. Is that right? I'm a part of my Savior. I'm a part of his word. Are you there with me? I'm the express image of the word of God. I'm that thought of God. Amen. Now being expressed. And if I'm the thought of God now being expressed, then every thought that God have, hallelujah, that thought of God is eternal. Is that right? And so the word of God is eternal. And if you're the word of God in expression this morning, amen, then you're eternal in God. Are you there with me? Hallelujah. So you can identify where you come from. I was watching, amen, a little thing they put online, and they were asking different people of different race and so, and they were asking them, you know, what nation they think they come from. And they were giving their opinion. But what they did, Brother Lambert, they took a DNA sample, amen, of each of those persons. And then they take that DNA, and Brother Garfield, they've got a sketch of the DNA of every regions of the earth. And so what they did, they were putting out their DNA, and they were tracing
Hallelujah, their genetic makeup, amen, to different parts of the world. And so they could tell you where you came from. No, you can say, well, I come from Africa. But when they study your DNA, amen, might be a little part of you is from China. A little part of you is from Asia. A little part is from Africa. Amen. And some who thought that they were poor, pure-breded, hallelujah, Caucasian. When they checked their DNA, they realized some of them were coming from way back in Africa. Amen. That's the earthly DNA. Amen. But what about the spiritual DNA this morning? If you run me back, amen, and tell me where I'm come from, amen, I can tell you that this morning, because my spiritual DNA, by the word of God, said I'm a thought of God. Amen. I'm the eternal thought of God being expressed in this day. Then if I am, then I must act the part that I am. Is that right? Hallelujah. Jesus, when he came, Brother Branham said he come in three sons' name. He come as Son of Man, Son of God, Son of David, three sons' name. He said when he came on earth in flesh, he was Son of Man, and he had to be, he could not be Son of God. Jesus never called himself the Son of God. Why? Because the scripture cannot be broken. Because the Bible said, for a prophet shall the Lord God raise up of your own brethren like unto me. Amen. And God called the prophets Son of Man. So when Jesus came on the scene, he called himself the Son of Man. Hallelujah. Was he a prophet? He was a prophet, but yet he was more than a prophet. Is that right? Hallelujah. Let us take him back to the Old Testament. Amen. Let us identify him in the book of Genesis. Everything was pointing to him. He was the Word of God. He was the Logos that came from God. He was the express image of God himself. Hallelujah. Moses, he did not see his face. Amen. But no, Moses knew exactly who he was. Hallelujah. Moses said, let me see the person who sent me to Pharaoh. He saw the back part of a man. That's right. Are you there with me? Amen. Hallelujah. He was the burning bush that was not consumed. Is that right? He was the one that speak out of the burning bush. He tell Moses, take off your shoes from off your feet, for where you're standing is holy ground. Hallelujah. He was the one who wrote the commandments on the tablet of stone. Who was he? He was God himself. Yes, sir. Is that right? But all he was doing, he was condescending. He was coming down. He was coming down to a form that you and I could know exactly who he is. For the word said, you shall know your God and shall do great exploits. Hallelujah. Glory. Amen, brethren. If you cannot identify him there, then you don't know the one that is with you today. Is that right? He was a God of Moses. He was a God of Joseph. He was a God of Jacob. Are you there with me? Hallelujah. He was the one that stood with them by the Red Sea. He was a voice that Moses became used to. He was the one, amen, that speak to Abraham. Hallelujah. Glory. Yes, sir. He's the same God. Hallelujah. And you, amen, having identified him, you've got to be identified in him. Hallelujah. You said, no, Brother Keith, how do we identify God? By his characteristic. Hallelujah. And if you belong to God, then by your characteristic, you're being identified today. Is that right? Hallelujah. Brother Branham said like this, unveiling of God. He said, so therefore, and just take the little thing that I'm going. He said, someone always going on, hallelujah, to me about a woman bobbing their hair. He said, now to me, as long as she does that, I don't care how saintly she does and how much she knows, she's still wrong. She wears shorts, hallelujah, in these clothes like that. I don't care what she does, how much she can sing, how well she, hallelujah, she can preach, whatever she do, amen, what kind of a life she lives, it is still one word is broken. See? It's got to be every word, not a sentence, a word, a word. So the Bible, hallelujah, is no private interpretation. It must be word by word. Hallelujah. The way it is written. It, hallelujah. We must believe it. Is that right?
Amen.
And not only believe it, but we must live it.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Is that right?
That's right?
Not only must we say we believe it, because everybody believe. Wake him up. Everybody believe, but we must live the word. And if we don't live it, hallelujah, then we don't believe it. We just say we do. Hallelujah. Basing back on what I said, amen, those disciples could not explain it, but they believe it. Do you believe the word of God?
Amen.
Then you're identified by the characteristic of the word of God.
Amen.
Is that right? And if the characteristic of the word is not with you, you don't believe God's word. Is that right?
Amen.
You can say, I do believe. You don't believe. Your actions speak louder than your words.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And they made their confession and lived to it. When all the rest of them walk away from it, they stayed with it. They believe it. That's the way to we do it. Amen. That's the way, hallelujah, you've got to do it. No matter what anybody else does, hallelujah, we believe it, and then we act upon it. That's the word of God.
Amen.
Can you say amen?
Amen?
Hallelujah. Glory. You see, brethren, we've got to make the word of God live.
That's right. Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
God is not dead.
No, sir.
He's alive.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We can't say he's alive unless you prove it by your life. Is that right?
Amen.
Your life got to point you at the word of God with an amen.
Amen.
And the word of God say this. And you said, well, the word of God said, but you see, no, you don't believe the word of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Those who believe the word of God will live by the word of God. The Bible said heaven and earth will pass away, but my word will never pass away.
That's right.
Is that right? Hallelujah. Jesus, my Lord. Amen. The Syrophoenician woman, she run to him. Thou son of David, have mercy on me. Jesus never as much as raised his head to her. Brother Branham said she had no claim on him as the son of David. It was a time yet, and it was a third time. Why? She was a Gentile. Hallelujah. Brother Branham said, my daughter have no claim on me as a husband. She can call me father, but not husband. Is that right? And you can't call him Lord unless he is your Lord. Glory. And you can cry out, Jesus, my Lord. If you don't do the works of Christ, you are none of his. Oh, the Bible say it like this. If you have not the Spirit of Christ, you are none of his. Do you hear me, brethren?
Amen.
Hallelujah. It doesn't matter what you say. You can dance about. You can clap. You can do anything. You've got to walk the walks of Christ. Hallelujah. Unveiling the mystery of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Amen. What we want is not the Christ of 2,000 years ago. Amen. But we want Christ. Amen. Living in the lives of the believer today. Bringing him out of history. Make him alive in your life today. Showing to the world that God keep his word.
Amen.
And if God keep his word, God can keep you by his word. Amen. Is that right? Amen. Heaven and earth, let it pass away, but God's word cannot pass away.
That's right.
Is that right? Yeah. Hallelujah. Oh, Jesus. Now notice a Gentile woman had no claim on him as a son of David, but blind Bartimaeus, it was his time. He was a Jew. Jesus, now son of David. Hallelujah. He was there in the time of the Son of Man. Blind Bartimaeus called him the son of David, but he was a Jew. Hallelujah. And Jesus had mercy on him. Do you know the time you are living in now? Oh, hallelujah. Jesus. But he said, "Whoa, whoa, look at that to right. That time when the third pole, you remember it. Amen, of all and everything. Amen, that woman said the right thing. Hallelujah, they've got to say the right word, the right thing to God. Is that right? You can't present a token that you don't have. Is that right? And he said, Christianity must present her token. And what is a token today? He said, it's a literal life of Jesus Christ.
Yes,
not as it lies there in the Bible, but as it's living your life. Hallelujah, your life. Let the word of God live today. And so if you live a double standard, you cannot claim the word of God. Is that right? You've got to let your word and your works punctuate the word of God with an amen. Then you can identify him as a capstone. Hello. When somebody else said Jesus Christ is a capstone, that word is empty. But when you by the Holy Ghost, amen, declare that word, amen, that word step from the page and live. And whatsoever you've got need of, God will grant it to you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Your life say, he is the seventh seal. Hallelujah. Anybody can say that, but if there's not a life to declare it, amen, it's just empty words.
Amen.
Is that right? Hallelujah. Glory. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. You know, you can declare that, you can say that. That's Hebrews 13:8.
Yeah.
But you know, the devil is not afraid of that word, but when that word is in the mouth of the anointed believer, amen, then that word means something that even the devil tremble at your presence. Are you there with me? Because you're not only saying it, but you know exactly what you're saying.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
He came first, amen, as a prophet, and they crucify him. Is that right? His own crucify him. The Bible said, for he came to his own, and his own receive him not. But the Bible said, to men, as many as receive him, to them give he power to become sons of God.
Amen.
Acts 1:8, you shall receive what? Power. After that, the Holy Ghost has come upon you.
Amen.
Amen. You said, Brother Key, what is this power? It's power to testify. Power to live the life. Power to make the word step from the page. Is that right? The believer is not without power. Are you there with me? Hallelujah. When you walk and testify of the word of God, that word is not dead. That word is alive. Because your life make that word alive.
Amen.
Oh, no wonder people can't have victory like they want. Amen. They say the thing that they desire. They pray about the thing that they desire, but they have no power. Is that right? Because their words are not identified. Hallelujah. Glory with the token. And the token is the literal life of Jesus Christ. And that word cannot lie. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Yes, sir. So then after the Holy Ghost came, he was then the Son of God, God in a spirit. He was the Holy Spirit, Son of God. He lived through the church ages as Son of God. Now in the millennium, he will be Son of David. Amen, sitting upon the throne of his father David. Amen, he's a Son of David. Hallelujah, he's a Son of Man now. And remember, between Son of God in the Laodicean church age, hallelujah, then they put him out. And in Luke, amen, he said he would be revealed again as Son of Man, the prophet fulfilling the rest of the scripture. Tie perfectly together, Son of Man, Son of God, Son of David. Hallelujah. What was it? It's the same God all the time, just changing his form in a morpho. He just changed it. Amen. It's a great drama to him. He's acting it out. Amen. Now he came as Son of Man, the prophet, done exactly what the prophet should do. Even that little woman, amen, in all of her sin, hallelujah, amen, they're all there at the well. She recognized him. She said, we know that Messiah is coming, which is called the Christ. Hallelujah. That's what he will do. See, she recognized because she was a predestinated seed. I'd like to pause there. She recognized why? Because she was a predestinated seed. This woman that had five husbands, that married five times, hallelujah, and the man she now have is not her husband, but yet she was predestinated. Is that right? Amen. What was it? When the light of the gospel shine right there before her, hallelujah, it exposed everything that was in her. Hallelujah. And the light of the gospel speak, amen, of this predestinated seed that was inside of her. Hallelujah. That Jesus said to her, go call your husband and come. And she said, I haven't got no husband. He said, yes, you've got five husbands, and the one you have now is not your husband. Is that the truth? You see, as a seed of God, you've got to allow the word of God to wash you.
That's right. Amen.
Is that right? You got to allow the word of God to discern you. You see, you can't fight against the word of God and still have life. Oh, hallelujah. Brethren, I say this to you. Anytime somebody come to the stage, we'll say, hallelujah, well, the word of God said this, but... Anytime you've got about a conjunction after you said what the word of God says, you're sitting in the seat of the scornful. Hello? Anytime you come, the word of God says, let your word be amen. Is that right? And let me tell you, that word is going to condemn you. Are you there with me? But he's going to condemn this flesh. But take it back over into the scripture. The Bible said, there is now therefore no condemnation to them that are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. When the flesh lead you, you say what the word says, and you say but. But when you step into the Spirit, there's no but in the Spirit. The word of God say it, and that settles it.
Amen.
Amen. Because heaven and earth will pass away, but God's word cannot pass away. Are you there with me?
Oh,
hallelujah. So if you quote St. Mark 11:23, hallelujah, if you will say to this mountain and shall not doubt in your heart, but believe whatsoever you say, all that you say. But if you have a but to the word of God, God is not obligated to keep that word. Is that right? That's why I challenge your brethren. Take side with the word of God against yourself. Let every man's word be a lie, and let God's word be true. And when the light symptoms rise up in your life, amen, say that's a lie from the pit of hell. For God's word say, by stripe I'm already healed.
Amen.
Oh, yes. God's word say, I am sealed. That settles it. Amen. Is that right? Amen. Hallelujah. Jesus. Hallelujah. Joel chapter 2 and verse 28. The Bible said, I will pour out in the last day my spirit. Hallelujah. Upon all flesh, I'll pour out my spirit. The spirit of God pouring out into the church. Is that right? Amen. Then said, hallelujah. Acts 1 and verse 8, come alive to you. For you shall receive power. Is that right? And you said, Brother Key, what is that power for? Because circumstance is going to shadow every life. There's going to be things this morning, Brother Lambert, you shouldn't be here. Because if you look at the things that happen around you, sometimes it's in your body, you don't feel good. Sometimes things that you could attend to, other things calling you, other duties calling you. Are you there with me? And you almost never make it this morning. If it wasn't faith in God's word, a little love for the word of God, you would not be here this morning, because everything around you is pointing in another direction. Amen. But God give to you the Holy Ghost, and that Holy Ghost in you is giving you a desire. You are calling out for something else. What is it? It's a deep calling unto a deep. Amen. Your soul is crying out for worship. Your soul is crying out, amen, to feed on the word of God. You've got to be washed by the washing of the water, by the word. Amen. But all hell begin to break loose around you. And if you're not careful, you are taken under. And you've got a good excuse, amen, not to be here. But in the name of Jesus, you're going to break every chain. You're going to break every chain. Break every bondage. Break every fetter and said, in the name of Jesus, I'm gonna make it. Hallelujah. Amen. Because it's not based on how I feel, it's not based on the lying symptoms around me, but it's based on God's word. There's something in me that is calling me to the word of God, and I'm responding to that call. Hallelujah. Amen. Jesus, hallelujah, then you know that he is with you. He's right there with you. He will not leave you. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. You're going to be able to identify him. Let me take a little of this here. So that is, he changed himself. He poured himself into another mask, into another form. Not another person went out of him. Called the Holy Spirit. Amen. But it was he himself. Hallelujah. He himself poured himself into the people. Christ in you. Is that right? Oh, because wonderful to think God pouring himself into the human being, into the believer. Is that right? Pour out. It was a part of his own drama. Amen. God, all the fullness, all that God had bodily was in this person, Jesus Christ. He was God and God alone. Not a third person or a second person or a first person. Hallelujah. But the person, God veiled in human flesh. Is that right? Hallelujah. God, he was all God. He was not part of God. He was all God. All the fullness of the Godhead bodily. In Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. Slow down a little bit. All that God was, he poured into Christ. Hallelujah. Amen. He kenos, he emptied himself. Wow. Brother Branham said, not like vomit up. No, 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 no. It's not a part of God. Well, all of God. Hallelujah. Amen. My God and Savior came. And Jesus was his name. Born in a manger. To the world he was a stranger. Amen. Then the prophet. It took a prophet. Amen. That saw in the back part of God's mind. Amen. That took it from cross. all that God was, he poured into Christ. And all that Christ was, he poured it in the body of believer. Amen. Can you see now who you are this morning? Hallelujah. You're shut up in amnesia. Hallelujah. The devil has lied to you all this time. Amen. But to bring you back to who you are. Amen. They said there's a cure for amnesia. It's not a tablet. It's not a medicine. It is to take you back to familiar places. Hallelujah. To where you were before. Are you there with me? Amen. Then you see your true identity. Hallelujah. The little boy never saw a mirror. Amen. But they show him a mirror. Amen. And in the mirror he was looking at himself. And oh, he stick his tongue out. And the boy in the mirror stick his tongue out. He could lift his hand. And the boy in the mirror lift his hands. Something is revealing to him. The boy in the mirror is mimicking him. But then it comes further than that. He start to realize it's not another boy in the mirror. He said, Daddy, Daddy, it's me in the mirror. It's me, oh Jesus. What a day when you begin to look at the word of God. And you begin to speak of Christ. Hallelujah. And when you speak of Christ, amen, a person, amen, start to come in plain view. And you realize it's not a second person of the Trinity. It's not a third person. It's not a first person. But all that God was and poured into Christ. And all that Christ is, he now pour into you. Hallelujah. And you realize the way you dress is not by chance. The way you act is not by chance. The way you talk is not by chance. But it's Christ in you. Seven thunders revealing you. It's Jesus Christ in the believer once more. Daddy, it's me. Daddy, it's me. Hallelujah. Glory. Jesus. So Paul bringing him closer to us by revelation in 1 Timothy 3 and verse 16. For without controversy, great is the mystery of godliness. For God, capital G-O-D, Elohim, the one who speak the word in Genesis and it came into being. God, in the Bible, refers it back. Anybody? Hallelujah. It's Elohim in the beginning. And Elohim without controversy. Great is the mystery of Elohim. For Elohim was made flesh. And we handle him. Elohim, veiling human flesh. The great Jehovah that cover all space and time. And everywhere was made man. Hallelujah. We handled him. Elohim. In the beginning, Elohim, and Elohim was made flesh and dwell among us. Hallelujah. Glory. What a thing it was for Abraham. He could not see the sun, no sign, no pregnancy of Sarah, not even any menstruation period or anything, but yet God said so. All the symptoms in the flesh that would tell you that it's possible were gone. But one thing he had to hold on to. You said, Brother Keith, that's a thin thread. But he's holding on to it anyhow. God says so. Yes. And if you can hold on to God say so, you're holding on to greater than the substance of this bottle. Are you there with me? Yes, if you can hold on to God say so. You don't need no other evidence. You don't need nobody to tell you anything. Because some people are waiting on somebody else to confirm something for them that God has already released in the word. Amen. But if you've got this morning, God say so. You got everything. How do you know it? God says so. Hallelujah. It is going to be well. How do you know it? God says so. Hello. Tomorrow's going to be better than today. How do you know? God says so. Where we're going to wake up one morning between 6 and 9, and we're going to leave out of here in the Mount Zion rapture showdown. How do you sure about that? God says so. Oh, this herd is going to bob and weave like a drunkard. How do you know that? God says so. Hallelujah. Jesus. I tell you, there's coming a day when there'll be no more bad high, bad teeth. No more false teeth, false and false. Are you there with me? All the limbs will return to the body. You'll be restored in your youth. For God say, I will restore. How do you know that? God says so. Is that right? I ain't care what science say. Science can say what science want to say. But God says so. Hallelujah. That they, hallelujah, are fighting the battle, and Joshua command the sun to stand still. Amen. Science claim, amen, that the sun never move. The earth is moving around the sun. Amen. I don't care what way it go, but the Bible said the sun stands still where it is in relation to the earth. Nothing move because God confirmed. Hallelujah. Amen. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sarah, all hopes. Even her womb was dead. And the life in him was, I'm sorry, was gone. The stream of his life had dried up. Her life had dried up within her. And yet he staggered not. He have nothing to go by. Nothing to go by. In other words, if you ask anybody, give them the case, it can't happen. He had nothing to go by. But the Bible said, and yet he staggered not at the promise of God through unbelief, but was strong, giving praise, knowing that God was able to perform anything he had said he would do. God say it, that settles it. Amen. Is that right? Amen. And brethren, why am I saying this? That you can look in your life this morning, and whatever you're struggling with, whatever you're waiting on, whatever you're looking for, hey, may you rest your hope, not on the lying symptoms of the world, but the fact that God make you a promise, whatsoever thing you desire, when you pray, believe. Hallelujah. You can have faith in God. And if there's a mountain in your life, say to this mountain, be thou removed and be cast into the sea, and don't doubt, and God will honor your word. Amen. Do you believe that?
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Sometimes we say, well, you know, it go on so long, I can't believe. I can't believe. But Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, amen, today, and forever.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. There is a way we've got to believe that word today. How is it going to be? I don't know. God said it. It's going to be that way.
Amen.
And that settles it.
Amen.
Amen. God say it. And that settles it. Oh, yes. Who is this great unseen person? Who is this that Abram seen in vision? Right at last, thought he was manifested in flesh before the sun came. God himself came to Abraham in the form of a man. At the end time, manifested, he saw him in a little light. One time he saw him in a vision. He saw him in his voice, he heard his voice. Many revelation, but just before the promised son, he saw him in the form of a man, and he talked to him and fed him meat and drink. See, notice God himself veil in human flesh. This is a part of his way.
That's right.
Is that right?
Amen.
And you've got something on your heart this morning, and you didn't know what was going to be said, but here I am this morning telling you to trust, and thus say the Lord. Hallelujah. Is there another word you could receive this morning? Trust on thus saith the Lord.
Amen.
Oh, Brother Joe made a statement, hallelujah, the other day. He said, oh, glory. He said when he was born, he had many problems, many sickness in his body. And the doctor said there was to be an operation to correct him. And it would take, in 1962, he would have been, amen, $600, a lot of money. But his father prayed, and he wrote a letter to Brother Branham. And Brother Branham turned the letter on the other side and wrote back and said, if you would believe God and pray in the morning and midday and in the evening, God will take care of your boy. Hallelujah. Amen. And God took care of it. But he tell of another person. Hallelujah. Amen. That she, amen, she went there to Brother Branham because she had a relative. Hallelujah. That was very sick. Hallelujah. And Brother Branham tell her, if you would believe God. Hallelujah. He said, but when she left the meeting, she started to doubt. She started to doubt. Hallelujah. And 40 years after, the person was still in the condition and died in the condition because she doubted what God's word say. And I tell you, brethren, oh, we've got to be careful because so much around you this morning is trying to tell you, don't believe, don't believe, don't believe.
Umar. Umar. Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Umar.
Brethren, I tell you what. If you look at the natural things of this life, they all point to unbelief. You leave out of a service, you're charged. You're going to your car, you switch the key. Something happened. You start to doubt. You start to drive down the road. You begin to look at things that are coming to your eyes. You start to trust in the natural and forget the supernatural. But brethren, I'll tell you, when you trust God, don't count the things that comes in the natural. They're all lying symptoms. But trust in the supernatural. The Bible said that Abram called those things that were not. Talk to me, church. Abram called those things that were not as though they are. Is that right? In other words, he wasn't looking for confirmation in his eyes, in his ears, in his mouth. No, he was trusting on what God's word say. Hallelujah. And the more he trusts God, the more he walks in the reality of the things that God said. Oh, hallelujah. But brethren, you got to come to a point where you got to hold that resolve in God. Hallelujah. You got to come to that point. Hallelujah. Like Esther. Hallelujah. She come to that stage. She was a last chance. Hallelujah. To go before the king. Amen. To represent her people. There was nobody else. Amen. That she thought. Amen. Would have done it. Amen. Everything point to her. And she said, if I perish, let me perish. But I must see the king. Hallelujah. Jesus. Listen to this, brethren. This is a part of his way. This is the way that he manifests himself to us. Manifests the eternal word. God, Jehovah, made flesh. Like St. John 1, in the beginning was the word, and the word was with God. In the beginning was Elohim. Hallelujah. Amen. Because the word, and the word was Elohim, and the word was made Elohim. Is that right? Oh, hallelujah. Like the attribute, see? It is in God. An attribute is your thought. God, in the beginning, the eternal, he wasn't even God. He was the eternal. He wasn't even God. God is an object of worship or something, see? So he wasn't even that. Amen. He was Elohim, the eternal. But in him was thought. Amen. He wanted to become material. Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah. Do you know that you are taught in the mind of God? And that thought were to become material? And do you realize you're not a thought anymore? You're not just a spirit, but you've got flesh and blood. You are God's thought made manifest. Hallelujah. And may I say to you now that the thoughts of God are eternal. Then Brother Branham said, and they are perfect. Is that right? That you're looking now at your imperfection. This is a tree that is dying, but it's a reflection that there's another tree that has eternal life. Oh, hallelujah. Glory. Jesus, we're going to leave here one of these days. Amen. Don't worry about that. Let your calling and your election show. Hallelujah. Amen. Brother Cosmo wrote a piece this morning. Amen. There. Amen. We all going to die someday. Hallelujah. It's not if we are going to do it. Amen. But listen. Hallelujah. Ask yourself the question. Where will I spend my eternity? Because sometimes the pleasures of today shadow your eternal destination. And because of the pleasure for a time, you live a life forgetting about tomorrow. But I ask you, if this is your last day on earth, would you live it the way you live it now? Huh? If this was your last day, would this be what you would be doing? The thoughts that is going through your mind, your plan for this evening, would that be your plan if this was your last day? Think about it. Hallelujah. Oh, Jesus. He said, notice through the ages, the same way by his prophets, he has revealed himself. Amen. Then wasn't exactly a prophet. They were gods. He was so far. What they spoke was God's word. They were the flesh that God was veiled in. They were gods. Jesus said himself, said, how can you condemn me when I say I'm the Son of God? And your own law say that them whom the word of the Lord came to was gods. So it was God form in a man called a prophet. See? Hallelujah. And the word of the Lord came to this man. So it wasn't the prophet. The prophet was a veil. Amen. But the word was God. Yes, the man's word. I won't act like that. Hallelujah. No, see what I mean? It cannot happen in that manner. But potentially it was God. See? He was a word of God in the form of a man called a man. Notice, he never changes nature. He only his form. Hebrews 13:8, he's the same yesterday, today, and forever. He was back then in the prophet. I asked you this morning, where is he today? If a but follow the word of God in you, he's not in you. But if you will punctuate the word of God with an amen, you'll just find him. He's manifested. Hallelujah. Amen. Behind 16 elements this morning, call a body. It is Christ in you, the hope of glory. Jesus. Hallelujah. Well, you know the word says this, but hallelujah. Amen. I'm going to live my life. You're going to die and go to hell. Is that right? You know, it's better not to know than to know what is the truth and don't do it. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. It's better you didn't know it. But I'll tell you, if you know it, you know that's God's word. You know that's what God's word say. Is that right? But you count yourself unworthy of eternal life. That word is not for me. It is for another day. The word of God speak, but it's not speaking to me. You're putting yourself outside of it. Is that right? But you've got to make yourself live that word of God. Hallelujah. Take side with the word of God. Is that right? Hallelujah. I don't know how I'm going to do it. I don't know how I'm going to keep it. But God's word say it. And I'm resting my eternal destination on what God's word say. That's the way God did. He bred this one to that one. To this one, to that one. Amen. To this one, to that one. Till he got exactly what he wanted. You're not members of the bride. You're not here by accident. Oh, hallelujah. I say you're not here by accident. Are you there? Amen, Brother Cosmo. Your father is from Malawi. Amen. And you were in Zimbabwe. Hallelujah. You had to be there to be educated. You had to come here. Is that right? Amen. That was God's plan for your life. There was a time you did not know it, but God knows it. Is that right? Amen. And God didn't bring you all this way. Amen. To lose you. Amen. He would be defeating his purpose. But there's a purpose in God's mind when God was doing all of that. Amen. And so if you've walked off the track, find your way back to the perfect will of God, because God will bless you in his perfect will. Is that right? Amen. Hallelujah. God know what he's doing. Is that right? Brother Garfield, you are from St. Thomas. And Sister Nadine is from here. Is that right? You had to meet up somewhere. Is that right? Because when you were born, from that day you were born, before you were born, amen, there was a light of God. Hallelujah. For a predestinated son of God. Is that right? And when you were born, it seemed like you were born out of region. Amen. But God had to cause, amen, things to happen. Hallelujah. Amen. And sometimes it seemed like it's out of God's will. But God knows exactly what he's doing. Amen. Until it come to that point. Jesus. So he said, that's the way God did it. He bred this one to that one. This one to that one. This one to that one. Till he got exactly what he wanted. That's how he come down. God unveiled himself in a pillar of fire down through, amen, the prophets. Then into the Son of God, which well, he was God. See, it's the same God bringing out exactly from perfection to perfection, from glory unto glory. That's the way the church goes. When you look the pattern through which God chose to bring you to this, you know that it had to be the grace of God. Amazing grace shall always be my song. For it was grace that bore my liberty. I never knew just why he came to love me so. He looked beyond. He looked beyond my fault and saw my need. Hallelujah. I shall forever lift mine eyes to Calvary, to view the cross. Look beyond.
My
Amen. So let me close here now. Notice he never changed his nature, only his form. Hebrews 13:8, he's the same yesterday, today, and forever. So he did not change his nature when he came. He's always a prophet. All down through the ages, same thing. The word, the word, the word, the word. See, he cannot change his nature, but he changes form. And he's in Hebrews 13:8. He had to come into human flesh. And nobody, no sexual desire, because that proves again our statement at the serpent seed. See, absolute. He said, not apples, sex. That's right. That had to be. Notice here, see, for any good man, look at those prophets back there, but had to be more than a prophet. See, in order to do that, he had to come to a virgin birth, showing that virgin birth proof. He had to be born virgin birth to take the curse off, the antidote. See what I mean? So it had to be sex to prove in his own coming. He came not in sexual desire, but through virgin birth. And he changed his mask from Jehovah to Jesus in order to make the redemptive work in the drama that he was acting out in God at the cross. So the Greek couldn't see him because he was hid from them in a human being. Notice his word to them, except a corn of wheat fall in the ground. God veiled in the form of man, hid himself from their view. They couldn't see. They could only see a man, but they predestinated seeing God. One saw man, the other saw God. And it was God veiled in a human being, made both of them right. But your faith is what that you could do see. You believe it? God veiled in human being. He was in the flesh, and that flesh was his veil. The veil was rent. See? That God might be made manifest. And so when he was on the cross, that veil had to be rented. Hallelujah. So the Bible says Moses had to put a veil over his face, because the Bible said when the word of God was in Moses for the people, even the face of Moses shone. And so he put a veil over his face that the people could not look to the glory of that which is abolished. And the Bible said, even today when Moses read, the veil is still over their face. But when Christ is revealed, that veil is taken away. Amen. Is that right? Amen. Hallelujah. They could not see God in plain view. In the Old Testament, God was hid when he was in the mercy seat. On the mercy seat, by a veil. In the Old Testament, God was in his temple. And the people came to worship like this. But remember, there was a veil that hid God. They knew God was there. They couldn't see him. The pillar of fire never appeared anymore. Did you notice? There's not one time in the scripture from the time that the pillar of fire went in behind the veil that it ever showed again until it became Jesus Christ. God was veiled. When he stood on earth, he said, I come from God. I go to God. Then Paul, after his death, burial, and resurrection on his road to Damascus, there was that pillar of fire again. What was it? Out from behind the veil, the glory of God. He said, glory to God. Hallelujah. And where is he again today? Brethren, he's not out there in the elements somewhere. But the word of God is nigh thee, even in thy mouth, amen. The word that we speak. There's something I've got to say to you to complete all of this. Brethren, that God that is Marfa is living in the believer.
Yes, sir.
Amen? And the proof that is there, the proof that is there, he will confirm his word to you.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen?
Thank you, Jesus.
And if you live by that word,
thank you, Lord.
God is never far from you. But if you ask of him,
thank you, Lord.
the Bible said, is a present help.
Thank you, Lord.
In the time of trouble.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
But brethren, if we try him and if we're in and out with God, you'll never see God manifested. You've got to come to the point like Esther. If me perish, let me perish, but I want God's way. Omen would say that this morning.
Amen.
Let me perish, but I want God's way. Amen. Hallelujah. God bless you this morning.
There's a song that says, I feel that I'm so far from you, Lord, but still I hear you calling me. Those simple things that I once knew, the memories are drawing me. I must confess, Lord, I've been blessed, but yet my soul's not satisfied. Renew my faith, restore my joy, and dry my weeping eyes. Take me back. Take me back, dear Lord, to the place where I first believed. Oh, take me back. Take me back, dear Lord, where I first believed. Say it again, say, take me, take. Oh Lord, take me back, dear Lord, to the place where I first. Oh, take me back. Oh, take me back.